There's a place in the ocean that you can't see, where two giant currents collide, creating a perfect storm of life. Swarms of sharks ride north in the warm current, their progress blocked by a wall of cold water. But for a few warm-blooded super predators, it's their private hunting ground.
Oh my God, one just bit the other one!
They will outswim, outthink, and outlast anything they hunt. The North Atlantic. It's late spring in New England. The warm river of the Gulf Stream pushes north, carrying with it some of the world's most extreme predators. The hidden appeal of this area lies in the collision of two opposing currents. From the north, the frigid Labrador Current, and from the south, the tropical waters of the Gulf Stream. Every summer, these opposing temperatures mix, igniting the growth of plankton and creating an explosion of life. Over 30 species of sharks, numbering in the thousands, make their way to this dynamic feeding ground. Veteran diver and underwater cinematographer Joe Romero is gearing up for a night dive with boat captain Brian Raymond. They're here to see if the warm Gulf Stream has arrived off the coast of Rhode Island.
We got something cruising on the outside here. I can't see what it is.
It's a blue shark.
Here he is, right here.
Blue sharks are cold-blooded. They need the warm waters of the Gulf Stream to heat their bodies. They come into these waters every summer, hunting for prey.
Oh, whoa, whoa, another one coming in from this side.
Man, they are all over him tonight.
More and more blue sharks arrive.
Right here, on the left again.
And they're hungry. Their presence can only mean one thing. The warm waters have arrived. The season has not begun.
Oh my God, I don't have to sleep after that. We should start packing up and going to get Greg.
If anybody's gonna know anything about what's going on out here with these sharks, it's gonna be him.
Now that Joe has evidence that the Gulf Stream has arrived, he heads back to shore to pick up colleague Dr. Greg Scommel. Greg's a senior biologist with the Massachusetts Marine Fisheries and one of the world's leading experts on sharks.
Good to see you.
Good to
this
see
is
you
where
too,
it all started for me, so I'm super, super excited to come back to Rhode Island.
Greg and Joe have a mission. Like the blue sharks, the majority of sharks that ride up on the Gulf Stream are cold-blooded. Once they hit the cold waters of the Labrador Current, they can go no farther. But there are three shark species in New England that are warm-blooded. They hit the cold wall and keep on going.
Joe and I put together a plan and formulated an expedition where we can go out and see very special sharks, you know, sharks that are endothermic, sharks that are warm-blooded. You know, the Mako shark, the white shark, maybe even the phantom shark, the poor beagle.
These three sharks, the Mako, great white, and poor beagle, are known as mackerel sharks, and they've evolved with special thermal abilities. They are endothermic, or warm-blooded. But why are they so different from their cold-blooded cousins? And what advantages does their warmer blood give them? The team heads back to the dive site where Joe saw the blues, 50 miles off the coast of Rhode Island. They're looking for the edge, that very narrow place where the warm Gulf Stream meets the cold Labrador Current. This early in the season, they expect to find cold and warm-blooded sharks swimming together. They search the horizon for any visible signs.
Right over there. You see it right there, guys?
Yeah. I see it.
You see it?
It's at 3 o'clock, maybe 150, 200 yards.
It's a tall dorsal, and it's brown, so it's like...
He's definitely brown. I'd love to see what that is.
I want to get a little closer to it.
The team deploys a drone to help identify what they're looking at.
Keep going, Eric. Another 50 yards.
Okay, slow down. Halt it right here.
Yeah. You see it, Eric? Oh. All right, keep going.
The shark there.
Hang on, okay. Stop.
You see him right there?
You should be right over him, Eric.
You should be seeing it right now. It is a hammerhead. This is a good size.
He is.
That's a big hammerhead.
It's a big shark.
So this animal doing this that much.
He's right over him. You know, we don't see those a lot off the coast of New England. That, to me, is amazing.
The hammerhead is a tropical shark, a cold-blooded species. It tells Greg and Joe they're on the warm side of the edge. They need to go farther north. For millions of years, this temperature edge has moved according to the seasons. Every summer, as the northern hemisphere tilts towards the sun, ocean temperatures rise, and the warm Gulf Stream pushes ever farther north, deep into the cold waters of New England. Many species of tropical sharks, like this large hammerhead, travel the Gulf Stream north to the edge of the cold water, hunting all the way. As the Gulf Stream pushes farther into New England waters, so do these predators.
It's really warm, though, because that's a very warm water species. And it doesn't feel that warm when you touch the water. The water feels a little bit chillier. So there's just these little kind of eddies forming where these animals can sit there and kind of work their hunts.
I mean, what a great welcome party to see a smooth hammerhead on my first trip out with you. I love it.
The smooth hammerhead shows that the collision of cold and warm water is moving north. While this cold water wall may be invisible to the human eye, for a shark, it's as real a barrier as an island or a reef.